Welcome to Industry Cloud Conversations. On this show, we introduce to you industry leaders and Microsoft partners who are on the forefront of emerging technology solutions that transform the way we all do business. Today's episode is all about the transformation that can happen when we combine the power of Microsoft Cloud with our ISV partners who are leaders in their industry.
How do you see us building trust, I guess is what I'm getting at here, in data end to end as we rapidly move into fields that are about mitigating emissions and sort of side effects of energy in a way? Because I think if we don't get that trust, we're not going to move very fast and very far.
Yeah, no, a good point. So first of all, the topic of CO2 storage is something that is very close to my heart. Personally, I was participating in research projects over 20 years ago looking at CO2 storage and co-authored a paper on CO2 storage and so on and so forth seismic or technologies to monitor CO2 storage. And CO2 storage is different from upstream oil and gas in the sense that, first of all, you're sending the fluids the other way. It's going down into the earth as opposed to coming out of the earth. That's relatively straightforward. You just point the arrow the other way. The physics are somewhat different at times, but more importantly, in oil and gas, you can drill a well and you can assess, I have success or I don't have success. In CO2 storage, you're going to need to be making a bet of injecting into something where you don't really have the ultimate answer upfront, whether the CO2 will remain in the ground. And the only way to deal with that, to minimize the risk of CO2 not staying in the ground but coming out again, is to do a thorough piece of work on analyzing and assessing the geological conditions and the reservoir conditions that are going to be present when you're trying to store the CO2. So the reliance on the data, the reliance on high quality data, is probably even higher than it is in upstream oil and gas. The need for the companies that participate in CO2 storage to have transparency and a public relations that give the public a trust in the CO2 storage is critically important. So the challenges we have from oil and gas are increasing both in the upfront and after the fact when it comes to CO2 storage to be dealing with the trust and to be dealing with the reliability of the storage that we're undertaking.
Yeah, very, very good points. I think, you know, I would say we're almost now with this data platform, the tools, and sort of having brought it all together in the cloud, where we can start to talk about a digital twin for the subsurface. And I know that, you know, it's a topic we have broached on and off through the years, but you see now that, you know, that is on the horizon here, that we can really design that and help, you know, and bring that to market and have that inform these decisions and create sort of at least a, you know, simulated assurance that things have been done correctly.
Absolutely. That's what we're working towards, both having the science in place, so the physics is well understood and modeled, having the automation that's going to be needed to drive updates regularly, as a digital twin of the entire system, including the subsurface. That has been something we've been dreaming about for decades. I see it becoming real now. We see that in enhanced oil recovery, and we also see the potential for the same technology to be applicable in CO2 storage, to continuously keep updating, monitoring what's going on, updating the plans, and improving the reliability of the activities we're doing. So huge potential, and I think the elasticity of elastic compute of the cloud, the automation that can be brought, among other things, by artificial intelligence, are going to be tremendously helpful to be achieving that goal. And that goal is going to be necessary for reliable storage and trust in that we have reliable storage when we're dealing with CO2 storage techniques.
Yeah, that's funny you said, because I've also mentioned like the notion of the compute fabric. I mean, if you look at the energy industry as sort of a forerunner in the high performance computing space, you know, now we have entered the era of AI supercomputers, and the technology, or the sort of the platform there, the hardware platforms, lend themselves very well to this space. And I think that's sort of the next frontier, personally, where this notion of running these complex simulations, being able to do it at the scale with the speed, automation on top to manage the, you know, the enormous amounts of data that, that are involved, offers a lot of hope. So I really look forward to evolving that kind of technology with SLB and continue this great partnership that we have between the two companies.
Well, funnily, Sverre, as you, as both of us know, but maybe not all the listeners know, and not are we both sitting in Houston during recording this podcast, but we're both from Norway and both from more or less, give or take, the same tone or the same region, certainly in Norway. I think that also colors a little bit our approach to the entire topic that we've been discussing in this podcast around digital solutions. And energy security and environmental concerns. So as Norwegians, we like to be tinkering with the technology and like to be on the forefront of technology. That's, I think that's a national characteristic. We are a big oil and gas nation and very much important, particularly for Europe, for the energy security that's around now. An enormous wealth has been built up in the country coming from oil and gas. A lot of that wealth has been invested intelligently and coming people to benefit this at the moment and for generations to come. But we're also a country with the country with the highest percentage of electrical vehicles, for example, and a very high environmental concern. And I think that colors a little bit the approach. We are going to need energy. The world needs energy to go around. The world needs energy to provide food and to provide prosperity to the population of the world as we see it today. And the energy demands are going to be increasing. But we can't afford to continue doing that with the level of emissions that we've had over the last few decades, because the environment will be terminally damaged, if you like, by those emissions. So we need to actively work to mitigate that. And in the energy industry, obviously, we have a huge role to play. In the digital solutions, obviously, there's a huge contribution that can be achieved towards making these challenges become solvable. And CO2 storage being one of the things directly addressing fossil energy sources, by all models I've seen, are an enormously important part of the energy mix also in a net zero 2050 timeframe. So we need to make those fossil sources environmentally friendly, and CO2 storage is the only way they can achieve this. And every piece of technology that we're collaborating on here is going to be relevant both for producing that energy and for mitigating the environmental damage. So I'm incredibly proud to be participating in the collaboration we're doing with Microsoft, the collaboration we're doing with the broader energy industry through OSDU, to drive the technology that will enable us to be more efficient and make better quality decisions, both for developing and producing energy and for mitigating the environmental impact that we're seeing from it.
So I think with that, I'll thank you a lot, Trygve, for joining me in this industry cloud conversations today. As always, great conversation. It's a great partnership between SLB and Microsoft. I want to sort of thank you for that again. And as I said, it's been really rich for us, and I'm really looking forward to the next chapter. And again, if we do a follow-up on this, I'm sure we'll have lots of new interesting things to talk about around the next corner. So thanks you again, Trygve.
Thanks for the opportunity, Sverre.